Hi everyone! Welcome to my review of XTAR Li-ion AA size batteries and L8 8 slot smart mixed use charger. So without further ado, let's just dive in. I'll start from charger unboxing. As you can see, it comes in simple or rather traditional packaging. There is not so much more to say about. XTAR L8 is a mixed-use charger. That means it can be used for charging lithium-ion batteries as well as nickel metal hydride, AAA and AA batteries simultaneously. Even if it looks kinda simple or generic, it seems to be made very well. Strong durable plastic construction with LED indicators built in on top of the device. Now let's take a look at XTAR Li-ion battery. It comes in pack of 4 in small plastic storage box. The battery itself is no different than the usual, so to say, AA sized rechargeable battery. It is only feels slightly lighter. On top of the battery we've got a very small discharge low voltage indicator, which is barely visible. It starts to blink if the battery is about to be completely discharged, and it also blinks during charging until fully charged. Some people might ask, what is the real difference between the usual, so to say, premium class nickel metal hydride rechargeable battery and the lithium ion ones? Firstly, it just lasts longer due to higher capacity. Secondly, it's capable of delivering higher voltage. And thirdly, it can run more recharging cycles during its lifetime. Here you can see the specifications. XTAR Li-ion battery has charge capacity of 2500 mAh or 4150 mWh, which is higher than usual. Let me do the little test. I want to measure an average voltage on fully charged AA size batteries of different kind. I'll start from EBL nickel metal hydride battery. On average, these batteries can deliver 1.3 volts, as you can see right here. Next, on Panasonic Eneloop Pro 2500, on average we've got 1.4 volts. And on XTAR Li-ion, we've got an average of 1.5 volts, just like advertised. Li-ion batteries could be a very good companion for pro-grade audio recording devices, like in this case with Zoom U44. It almost doubled the battery life. I was capable to run a session for almost 4 hours in 24-bit 96 kHz with 2 connected microphones, phantom power on, headphones out connected to the Cubasis on iPad Pro. Or as in this case, whereas I could extend the battery life on my Zoom H2N to almost 30 hours of continuous recording on single charge. Li-ion batteries also perform very well in all kinds of lighting devices, like for example this photo lamp. It runs longer and it stays consistent during the process, whereas in case with nickel metal hydride battery, the light quality condition will decrease through the time. But let's come back to the audio. I personally was interested in lithium-ion batteries because nickel metal hydride batteries could not last long enough during sessions with my Tascam X6 audio recorder. I'm always using 96 kHz 32-bit float multi-channel configuration, so as you could imagine, the battery drained very fast. With XTAR AA rechargeable, my Tascam X6 lasted for over 9 hours of continuous recording with 3 mono channels plus master mix. Phantom power on, screen is always on medium brightness and headphones monitor out. But that is not all. I've also tried XTAR AA rechargeable with portable charger power bank in order to charge small devices. The point was to see if there would be any difference between nickel metal hydride batteries and lithium ion batteries used as a source in this case. I have to say that I was capable to fully and quite fast charge my headphones and also my small Samsung Galaxy tablet. It started to charge from zero and went to 47% until it got completely depleted. I have to say that XTAR batteries got also quite warm during this process. XTAR has its own emergency power bank smart charging solution, XTAR BC4, which can charge up to 4 batteries of any sort or be used as power bank to charge other devices. Unfortunately, at this time of filming, I could not get my hands on XTAR BC4, but I'm looking forward to the opportunity, so to say. It has to be an interesting device to test out. It is maybe not a very common way of use, but it could come very handy in some sort of situations, like for example, during working on the location where one can charge small pro-grade devices, or just catch up with the favorite TV show. XTAR producing many other models of chargers, including quite sophisticated premium class multifunctional devices. I'm using XTAR batteries and L8 smart charger for over a couple of months by now, and have to say that I'm very impressed with it. It works better than any other nickel metal hydride batteries. It significantly improves battery life during sessions, and it has much more recharging cycles during its lifetime, therefore improves sustainability of rechargeable in general. It feels like a new generation of AA rechargeable batteries, although it is more expensive than the premium class nickel metal hydride siblings. At this point, it's also bringing a lot to the table, starting from significantly longer discharging time / battery life and ending up with a small low voltage indicator on top of the battery. XTAR L8 smart charger has all kinds of protections, dry battery detection, and it also capable of reviving over discharged batteries. I would totally recommend it to try out to anyone. And that would be all for now. Thank you for joining in. Thumbs up if you liked it. Please subscribe, and I see you all next time.